Howdy there neighbors, Ian with etrailer here. Today we're going to be looking at the Redline U-bolt kit for round axles. Let's get into some features and then that installation. This particular kit is going to be great for your camper, car hauler, or utility trailer. This one is meant for a 3-inch round axle. There are options for square axle as well. Some measurements to keep in mind just in case you've got a trailer that's going to be sitting pretty close to those leaf springs in the center. From the top of the bolt down to the bottom, we've got 7 1/16 inch, and again, the 3 inches in the middle here for our spacing for the axle. They are rated from anywhere from 5,200 pounds to 7,000 pounds on that axle. And with those basic features out of the way, let's go ahead and get right into that install. So these leaf springs are pretty rusted. You can see the ones in the rear here have shifted even. So we're gonna need to get these out. With these as rusted out as they are, I'm gonna go ahead and just cut them off. I've got a cutting wheel here. Of course, always use safety protection when you're using all that. Eyes and ears every time. Now we're gonna go ahead and take these end shackles loose. I've got a 7/8 wrench box end on the back and then a 13/16 to take this front end off. There's gonna be this one and then two in the middle and one at the end, just the same as this on the hangers. Now with all our bolts loose for our end shackles of the springs, they're good to come out. So we'll just slide those out carefully. Just watch out for your axle, make sure it's well braced because it will shift around. And we'll push both of those out of the way and work on getting this end right here taken off. There's nothing to hold as far as hardware on this outside edge, but it'll be a 1 5/16 on the inside. I'm just gonna run the impact to get that off there for us. Go ahead and drive this out of the center hole. Now we're gonna get our equalizer block in there, and that's just gonna slide into place. This wet bolt here is just going to sit through and into this square slot. We're gonna go ahead and get the castle nut on the back side of this equalizer bolt. There is not a torque spec for this, but we're just gonna go snug and then put the cotter pin in. So we wanna orient the hole so that it lines up with the slots on the castle nut. We'll just kinda snug that down. We don't wanna go too hard because the intent is to keep this from binding. It should always be able to move freely and adjust as it goes down the road. Here we're just about snug and almost lined up. You just have to do that a little quarter turn or eighth of a turn at a time to get that hole to line up. And then slide that cotter key through and bend your tabs sticking out for the cotter pin up out of the way. We're gonna go ahead and get this spring hung up here. Easiest way I've found, just kind of worming it in and then rotate into place once we've got at least one side through, lining up that center pin with the hole that is on top of the axle. And once we've got that into place, we'll just go ahead and get our hardware. And while these are going in for this particular trailer, eyelets are gonna go on the front of this particular spring. Same situation in the rear, eyelets are in the front. So make sure you've got that orientation right, otherwise you'll have to pull the whole thing apart and start over. Then our shackle bolts are gonna line up with the hole here. They're gonna feed through the face just like when we took them off. May have to get underneath it and apply pressure downwards or left or right to get that hole to line up. The nut is a locking type. You'll see this end has these little hash marks almost. That's where that's going to lock onto our threading on the other side. So one side will allow you to thread it on by hand. And if you're having an issue, it's probably because you've got your nut upside down. And I felt like that was definitely something worth mentioning, so that way you don't destroy any of the nice new hardware you got. And we're gonna go ahead and put our brackets up here, and then the U-bolts will come from underneath and then slide into the bracket. We'll wanna make sure again that the center pin is lined up. And then we'll just thread these all the way down. And then same on the back side here. This U-bolt up underneath, thread it down. We'll wanna make sure that plate's sitting nice and flush against the leaf spring there as much as possible. Don't wanna have any gaps or have it sitting off of it for when we go to torque down. And then we're gonna wanna go through and torque to spec. I do try to just kinda jump until we get to our torque from side to side, so that way we've got equal, or at least somewhat equal lengths coming up out of the studs. And just double check the instruction guide for that torque spec. And we're gonna run through and tighten down all these spring eye bolts and nuts. What you wanna do is just kinda get those snug at first, and then we're gonna use a hammer to just drive it down the rest of the way until that collar's all the way in and up against the shackle hangers here. I got that one pretty snug already. Tighten down, and you'll have to repeat this process as you go along of just tightening down and then buttoning it back up as far as the hammer, trying to get that end all the way to your hanger. As I'm going through tightening these down, I wanted to make sure to mention that these don't have a torque spec specific for these spring eye bolts. You'll just have to get them just snug enough where you're still going to allow movement and allow travel for the leaf springs in the hangers themselves. We are going to be tightening all of these down. It's not just the ones on the equalizer there. So just run through, same process, front and rear shackles, and then complete on the other side as well. And that's going to conclude the look at and installation of our Redline 3-inch round axle U-bolt kit. My name's Ian with etrailer. Thanks for watching.